Hey, Dr. Tim Turlip here. Welcome to 5 Minutes to Vitality. And who would have thought that getting clean could be such a downright dirty business? Well, in a recent study that was released in the National Academy of Sciences that was performed at the University of California and the San Diego School of Medicine, they looked at a substance called triclosan. And if you're at home and you pull up any bottle and you look at a bottle of shampoo, you look at a liquid hand soap, you look at a deodorant, most toothpastes, you're going to find triclosan as an active ingredient in. As a matter of fact, 75% of commercial use for antimicrobial, meaning a substance that's against bacteria and viruses, will have this substance in it. But what they were looking at the University of California School of Medicine was they were double checking how safe is this. Well, one of the things that they found is that it really is not safe at all. Now, it was a study that was done on mice, but what they actually found was that it actually increased the rate of hepatic or liver disease, including scar tissue and cancers, at a dramatic rate. So it also made the liver tissue very, very susceptible to other cancer-causing agents as well. So tumors would grow bigger, tumors would grow faster, and they would actually be more fatal than in otherwise was the case when not exposed to triclosan. So triclosan is used for this idea of eliminating these bacteria, these viruses that can create infection. But other studies are showing us that it's no more effective just to Dove soap, a liquid soap that has no triclosan in it, a shampoo that absolutely has no antimicrobial stuff. There's actually another one called triclocarban, but triclosan is actually more widely used. Interestingly enough, most municipal water supplies use chlorine in them to eliminate microbes in the water supply. When we use an antimicrobial substance like triclosan with the chlorine in the water, that soapy, hot, steamy substance actually gets together and forms chloroform, which is another cancer-causing agent. So the stuff is not really great. It's also been known triclosan to cause hormone disruption in the human body. It causes abnormal muscle contraction. Pretty dangerous stuff. Interestingly enough, it is one of the 7 most common commercial grade chemicals found in America's waterways, our streams and our creeks and our rivers. On human studies, 97% of women's breast milk, 97%, actually had trace amounts of triclosan in it. And 75% of all urinalysis, men and women, across the entire nation contain triclosan. So it's a very, they can use the word ubiquitous, meaning found every place, substance that has a great deal of hazards. Now, particularly when other studies are showing it does nothing to eliminate upper respiratory infections, GI infections, it doesn't alter that rate of that at all. As a matter of fact, in studies looking at chronically or people who are sick on an ongoing basis, where you'd think they'd be weakened and maybe using something like this would be more helpful to prevent infection, they actually found a greater rate of fever, a greater rate of cough, a greater rate of runny nose, and people are chronically ill using triclosan than in soaps that don't incorporate it. So if you want to be clean, and clean is good, right, make sure that you're not using triclosan and other antimicrobial substances. Even 10 years ago, the CDC was coming out and saying, we need to stop using triclosan. It's not necessary and is hazardous. 7 years ago, articles in the Journal of the American Medical Association saying the same thing. So get clean, but do it without triclosan. And thanks for joining us. Look forward to seeing you the next time.